First, though, we do want to get to the latest on what could be a copycat crime. Another woman attacked by an acid-throwing female. It's the second such an incident in a week. Betty Nguyen has the story for us this morning. Betty?
Yeah, it's just awful. This latest assault took place in Mesa, Arizona. The 41-year-old victim, a mother of five, says it simply came out of nowhere.
It was early Friday afternoon when Derry Velarde was getting out of her car at home.
There was a woman walking up, you know, from the back side of my car. She had what I thought was a glass of water in her hand, and then she just stopped abruptly and looked at me and just threw it in my face.
She was splashed with what she originally thought might be water. It turned out to be acid.
It just instantly was like fire. It started burning.
Velarde was left with severe burns on her face, neck, and along her arms. The incident was eerily similar to one that occurred last Monday in Vancouver, Washington.
My heart stopped. I almost passed out.
28-year-old Bethany Storo was also attacked as she left her car. Again, it was a female stranger throwing acid.
It's absolute hatred of the highest degree.
Writer Victoria Schofield studies culture and the politics of South Asia, where acid attacks are far more common, and the culprits are usually men.
It is probably in the present day one of the most demeaning forms of punishment that you can think of to destroy someone's face.
And that's why police say it's rare for these kinds of assaults to be random acts.
This type of crime is usually personal in nature.
But Velarde, who is going through a divorce and recently started a new relationship, says she doesn't know who her attacker is and can only speculate about a motive.
She wanted to make sure she disfigured me so that no one would want me.
Paramedics and police say Velarde stopped the burns from getting worse by quickly getting into the shower and rinsing the acid off of her body. Erica.
Oh, just an awful story. Betty, thanks.